Sometimes you just have to be careful of what comes out of your mouth. But today I want to deal with two words, yet and but. Because both of these words, they can either be detrimental to you or they can be profitable to you. It just depends on how you use them. We're going to go to English class real quick. These two words are what they call a conjunction. A conjunction is when you take two clauses or two sentences and you join them together by the conjunction that you put in the middle. Now, con, the prefix of conjunction, con means to add to. But this is very important. Junction means it's going to get added right here, right now. So you have to be very careful when you use your conjunction, because what you get ready to add to what was said is what you're going to have. Lord have mercy. I chose these words because there is a difference between them. Depends on when you use them and how you use them. Yet and but can be the difference between you being sick and getting healed. It depends on how you use the word yet and but. It may be the difference between you being poor and debt-free. It depends on how you use those words. It may be the difference between you being a lender and being a borrower.
Impede your progress. They'll cause you to doubt God right after God made you a prophet. I'm a person that uses yet. And departure in the past. It's time to turn that but into a yet. Everybody stand to your feet. Some of us are living in defeat because God wants to bless us. But the word but keeps us down. You know, we look at, we didn't have no mama, we didn't have no daddy, I didn't finish high school. Every time God promises something and gives you a dream, he said, yeah, God, it sure looks good, but. And some of y'all are sick right now, and you're carrying something, and the reason why you can't call mama head, so you say, well, I know you're a healer, God, but mama head. You know, when you go to the doctor, they want to know what your mama had and what your daddy had. They thought I had diabetes one time. They wanted to know, was your mama diabetic or was your daddy diabetic? What the hell are you doing with me? I'm a healer. Even if they did have diabetes, yet I'm a not healer. You don't have to take what the enemy gives you. Yet, put the thing a whole lot different than doctor. God says, I know God said this, but I don't accept what the enemy brought. Yes, said, no matter what the devil shows me, I don't believe God. God said, you're going to save your children. Y'all know I know you said it, but I don't see them, they don't call it. They strung out on crack cocaine. You need to say, yes. And then the Bible said, if you rejoice in the Lord, and despite of everything you're facing, we heard this morning, God bless God, God bless you. If you rejoice in God, in the face of trial, then the Bible said, he'll cause your feet. He'll cause your feet to be like hinds feet. In other words, he'll strengthen you. And then the Bible said, he'll make me. Even if I don't feel like rising to the top, just like a trivial, I rise to the top. He'll make me. If I rejoice, he'll make me rise up and walk on my high places. Some of you all today, God will raise you up over your circumstances. You don't have to excel, just like your mom. You don't have to excel. But the devil is offering. Look at your neighbors and stop the God. I think that's why he called us sheep. A sheep don't blood. Go to you. Look at your neighbors, see if you see any horns on them. If you see some horns, say your horns. Sheep don't blood. I had a dream. crossed over in my family head. I listened to Gene Patterson. When he was talking about his illness, it's on YouTube. And he was always like, he accepted his condition. You know, he was very calm about it. He said, well, my brother had it. I think he said something like, my uncle had it. So it was almost like he was saying, I'm expecting it. You know, it's not even accepted. And I sit there and watch that. I'm like, God, we don't have to accept anything that God died on the cross for us not to have. Good enough about it. Yeah, my mom was a diabetic, but God healed her. My father was a diabetic. He took insulin every day in his stomach with a needle. But I am a weak woman. My mom had cancer when she died.
Thank you. Oh, Lord.